Just give me a minute. I'm just setting up things. Okay, friends, so here we are with our esteemed guest, Mr. Gulshan Khanna. Sir, आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है गेसु संवाद में. और आज गेसु संवाद का ये 10वां सेशन है, विच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेशन फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. और आज के सेशन में आपकी उपस्थिति ने इस संवाद के सेशन को और भी महत्वपूर्ण बना दिया है. और दोस्तों, हमारे जितने भी पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं उन सबसे मैं एक बात कहना चाहता हूँ. पता नहीं जिंदगी में मैंने कितनी बार भाषण दिया होगा, कितनी बार बड़े बड़े लोगों के साथ मीटिंग की होगी, कई संवाद के सेशन भी कर चुका हूँ, कई वेबिनार कर चुका हूँ, लेकिन फिर भी कभी कभी यू फील वेरी हम्बल एंड टुडे इज द डे फॉर मी. क्योंकि आज हमारे साथ गुलशन खन्ना सर जो हैं वो हमारे गेसु के शुरुआती दौर के हमारे न सिर्फ सीनियर है बल्कि मैं कहूँगा सुपर सीनियर है. और सिर्फ सीनियर नहीं है लेकिन अपने कामों के कारण हमको इंस्पिरेशन देते हैं. तो आज मैं उनके साथ आपका तारुफ कराऊंगा, उनके साथ आपका परिचय कराऊंगा, बहुत सारी चीजें हम सीखेंगे उनसे. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. ये आप सबको हम पहले ही बता ही चुके हैं कि गुलशन खन्ना सर जो हैं वो मैक्स प्रो इंजीनियर्स के सीईओ हैं, एमडी हैं. लेकिन सबसे बड़ी बात है कि गेसु के एक पिलर हैं और हमारे साथी हैं, हमारे एलुमनाई हैं. तो सर, पूरे गेसु परिवार की ओर से और उज्जैन वाले ग्रुप की ओर से, उज्जैन वाले एक बहुत बड़ा परिवार है जिसमें 1.5 लाख मेम्बर हैं, जहाँ पर हम इस गेसु संवाद को लाइव स्ट्रीम करते हैं. तो सर, उन सब लाखों लोगों की तरफ से भी आपका मैं अभिवादन करता हूं और आज के सेशन की शुरुआत हम करते हैं. सबसे पहले तो मैं कहूंगा कि सर आप बहुत अच्छे लग रहे हैं. यू आर लुकिंग डैशिंग इन दिस टाई. ये जो टाई में बहुत डैशिंग लग रहे हैं.
थैंक यू पुनीत.
हाँ जी सर.
फर्स्ट थिंग, लेट मी हैव द प्रिविलेज to be with my people, with my friends and all of you after a long time. I had a very good respect for my professors, friends and all the peoples. So all my friends, good evening. This is your colleague Gulshan Khanna. And definitely, I love to be with you again and again for such type of webinars and such type of interactions. I don't want to tell much about myself, just a simple briefing. I started after my schooling in 1968, when this college was a joint college between Polytechnic College and Engineering College, and we started from those days. And we decided, okay, which where to go, because region is schooling, everybody is confused. Somebody want to become doctor, somebody want to become engineer, somebody want to choose to CA professionalism, and some other people they are looking for hard earning, easy earning, fast earning. So basically it was a very confusing stage where you want to make your career. Yeah. So again, it's a turning point for everybody, not for me, for everybody. So we decide whether I should go to engineering or I should go to medical or somewhere else. Yep. Once you decide you wanted to be an engineer, you should be focused, because reason is it cannot be a stopgap arrangement. Today I am in the civil department, tomorrow I will go to chemical, third day I am going to mechanical. So once I have taken the decision, yes, I wanted to be mechanical engineer, it was firm decision. Oh. the day one, because the old time it used to be 5-year engineering course,
yeah,
and the 4-year engineering course, and that time the allocation of the branch used to be at the first year.
Okay.
So used to be the common.
Okay.
So, but I was determined. I wanted to be a mechanical engineer, and we started. So, like many people, my friends, I remember all my old friends, they are in very top class positions in most of the big industries.
Mm-hmm.
They are there. So, I started and passed out in 73.
Mm.
And again, once you are in the flaring cover, you get a better opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
I got the options to work in Grasim Nagda because my parent want me to be somewhere very near to Ujjain. Mm-hmm. So options near to Ujjain was either Grasim Nagda, mm-hmm, or Sri Sindh Ujjain.
Yeah.
After taking the training at Grasim Nagda,
mm-hmm,
I started my career with the Sri Sindh at that time. I remembered it. It used to be one of the pioneer man-made fiber industry. So again, that time also you have to decide your goal.
Mm.
What you wanted to be in which type of line?
Yep.
Because options are open for you.
Yep.
Again, engineer should not be confused. Basically, today I wanted to be in the petrochemical. Tomorrow I can be in the fertilizer. Third day I can be in steel. Fourth day it should be in the man-made fiber. Or it can be paper and pulp. And many, many options are there.
Mm-hmm.
So, engineer has to choose his line. Whether he wanted to make the career in one particular line, again, it is a stopgap arrangement.
Hmm.
Some people may think over, no, I wanted to make my career in the software industry.
Hmm.
Some people will say, no, I wanted to be in the operation side. But I decided, no, I wanted to make my career in polymers. Why polymer? Simple question for everybody. Our daily uses, 80% things are from the polymer derivatives. All clothings, all shootings, all shoes, spectacles, hair, your cosmetic, everything polymer. How the polymer comes? Polymer comes from the refinery. So now all derivatives today we say we have 120 plus type of polymers. And it's still going on. So you choose your line, which line you wanted to go. So I decided, let me start my career with the polymers. Now, polymer is what?
Hmm.
Polymer is Nagda, Grasim Nagda, but it is man-made fiber polymer. It is not a petroleum polymer. Sri synthetic used to be polyester and nylon, which is a polymer product from the refinery. I started career with Sri synthetic. Executed the project successfully. Now, when the project is successful, the option is what? You work there in that plant either as an operational person or you take care of the maintenance.
Yeah.
Now, again, engineers are in the dilemma. Whether I should continue with the maintenance. Maintenance is a service to service industry. Always your operational people will always ride on you for everything. Blame is on the maintenance. Machine is not working, maintenance problem. Machine is not producing, maintenance problem. Machine, there is accident, is a maintenance problem. Or suppose you are the operation, you don't have the proper vision for lifelong. Means if you are starting in operation, you are in one company for one time, lifetime. No, it's the right time to change because I want to be only in the polymer and projects and polymer and projects.
Sir, I would like to ask you one question. What we really learned from you from this wonderful opening is that one must choose where he wants to go, what he wants to do. So first thing is engineering. Second thing is you made your mind that it has to be man-made fiber.
Yes.
Which is great. Thirdly, you said project management. I want to understand, at what point in your life you decided that I am going to be a project management person?
See, I have mentioned to you in Citizen, after my project, they have given me the options to become the maintenance in charge. Now, I worked in maintenance also for some time, but it used to be no time limit, no appreciations, no motivations, and the people used to talk always the blame game. Once you want to take a challenge, you want to come up in your life, definitely you have to think positively where you want to lead the show. My turning point, changing from maintenance to project, and I decided in lifetime, from that time onward, I will be in the project and project. Means first thing, I wanted to choose between the maintenance to project, and I decided to be in the project, number one. Number two, I want to be in the polymer and membrane fiber, lifelong. That's my mission and ambition.
I think there's a great determination. There's a great determination, great clarity of thought.
And thank you.
And everyone who is with us in this session, I'm telling you, there is much more to learn from Bhushan Khanna sir. And he is a hardcore engineer. But if you really want to understand how an engineer works, how an engineer thinks, I think we have a role model with us.
Thank you.
And sir, sir, there are many students also who would be listening to us, watching you today. And, and many of us, many of our alumni who are so, so junior to you, we all would like to know from you, because I don't think I would find another role model for an engineer, how an engineer engineer's mind works. And I would like to ask you, sir, how in your experience you feel an engineer is different from other people? What makes an engineer different? Please tell us.
And give me the simple, smallest example. Many people, those who are confused, means they are not focused, they are not determined, they are looking sometime this way or that way. So, engineer, always, whenever they will be working, they will be working with the clear idea, clear, clear vision, and there should be clarity what is required. First thing is, engineer cannot be in the double mode. Engineer has to be focused on the job, mission, result, and the final deliverables. Again, engineer mind has to be innovative. Engineer cannot be different type of version. So he has to set his goal, and then in his goal, he has to achieve the thing. So I was giving the simple example. Once you decide you wanted to be engineer, you should be very clear. Your thought process should be in the same line, and it should be consistent. It should be really approachable, and it should be productive. You should be productive. You should be proactive also.
Okay.
So that's why basically, engineer cannot become politician.
Yep.
So you have to be straightforward. Engineer means, if you are wrong, you have to say wrong. You have the capability to say wrong. Because I was giving you one simple example. You cannot think or compromising with the safety and the quality. Moment. Now, even it is costing heavily to the client, to anybody. But if suppose the things comes on safety and the quality, engineer has to stand, sorry, here I will not compromise. Simple, smallest example will tell you, we are playing with the life of the people. We are working with the people. We are working for the people, working with the people. Now, take the simplest example, a doctor. what worst he can do if suppose he do something wrong. Mm. Suppose he doing operation, he do something wrong. Ultimately, he will make the loss to the one person where he is operating. But suppose a engineer, he is compromising with the safety and the quality. Mm. What disaster he will make. Oh. He will kill thousands of people. If suppose there is a blast in the factory, innocent people will die. Yeah. So engineering means you are firm on your idea, firm on your vision, and you are not compromisable. But other people, definitely on the circumstances, they will change their way. But engineers never compromise on their ideology. That's the difference between engineers.
That's a great perspective you have given us, because most of the times people say doctors are responsible for lives. But today you have given us a new perspective to think upon. Yes, we engineers, we play a very crucial role in the society. Just many lives are dependent on us. On that note, I would like to ask you, doctors have an oath. But engineers generally, I never heard of an oath for engineers.
No, we are taking moral oath.
Yes.
We are also taking indirectly a self-oath.
Yes.
Okay, officially we don't declare we are taking oath, but in our visions, in our policies, in our ideology, we take oath in case client insists us also to compromise on the safety and the quality and some type of ethics. We will not be compromising at any condition. We will leave the project, we will leave the job, but compromising this ideology, it will not help. I am giving the simple example. The same line. Suppose a person doing something wrong, a civil engineer is doing the structural design, and mechanical engineering is designing a vessel or pipeline, or electrical engineer is sizing a cable. Is designing a philosophy on controls and DCR. If is doing some deviation in the design, what will happen? He is going out of the job. He will not come in. Ultimately, if suppose tomorrow there is an accident in the plant, who will be responsible? Okay, responsibility will lie with the persons like us, those who are in the same position. But his atma will not forgive because he had done the blunder.
Yep.
Tomorrow, the authorities cannot catch hold of him.
Yep.
But internally, he will feel the guilt in his lifetime that he had done the blunder is in life. So that's basically a core difference between the right design and the wrong approach.
Yes, sir, I have got a great insight here, and I want to share with you, and I would need your guidance on this. Till now, till date, I haven't heard of an engineer's oath. But after listening to you today, I think in GESU, we should introduce an engineer's oath. I think that will be something, that initiative will mean a lot of things to a lot of people.
During the conversations, I think once we are going and taking our final degree marks, we should talk in our lifetime, we will not sell our ideology and we will not compromise on the safety and the quality. These two words, safety and the quality, it should go in the blood of every engineer coming out of the college.
क्या बात है सर? तो सर मुझे लगता है कि आपके साथ मिलकर ये ओथ मैं जरूर लिखूंगा.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. यू आर गोइंग टू
जरूर शामिल करेंगे.
ट्रू. नेशंस को सपोर्ट करने के लिए, वर्ल्ड को सपोर्ट करने, ह्यूमन बीइंग को सपोर्ट करने के लिए दिस इज नेसेसरी दैट एवरीबॉडी शुड बी टेकिंग दिस ओथ. Now coming back to the same thing, see again polymer, you had a small polymer basically in series synthetic polyester and nylon. Then once JK used to be that time the pioneer fiber plant in India, more bigger than Reliance. So everybody was having the vision, I should be in JK. I decided, let me go to JK. JK is not only two polymer, by five polymers. It also staple fiber, also polyester, also polypropylene, also nylon, also so many things. So you have the better chance of learning more and more polymer. Not polymer, but polymer manufacturing also from the raw material. Because reason is, this is that upward integration and downward integration, fiber to polymers, another thing. More and more learning has come up on account of, because reason is, your value goes up once you have a better knowledge. And again, my word is, you should become the specialist. You should not be the generalist. You know, every engineer should focus more and more better idea. So I should be a specialist. So your value goes up, your market value goes up. I work from JK Synthetic all projects in Tanzania, Petrofil, Baroda, Ahmedabad, Mathura Refinery, Kanpur, Khatima, Jhalawar, and all the projects for 15th year.
Sir, एक बीच में एक थोड़ा सा suggestion आया है. अगर हम थोड़ा सा पीछे होके बोलेंगे, तो आवाज आपकी थोड़ा clarity के साथ आ रही है.
Okay, done.
You are so passionate. You are so passionate. When you start talking.
Good. That's okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, the JK Synthetic was the gold mine for all the polymer peoples.
Yeah.
Many projects in Tanzania, Kenya, Petrofil, Baroda, STPS, Suspira, Bombay, NACL, and so many type of project. Once you handle, your market value goes up. Yeah. You are better acquainted with the polymers and polymer technologies, how it comes, how it works. So, long 15-year durations, once I have worked in JK Synthetic, definitely people from DuPont, Arkemtech, and other people, they have eyes on you. They come on, Mr. Khanna, why you don't join DuPont? And it used to be the one of the milestone for everybody to work with the DuPont. Because DuPont is the only, not only, but among the many technology suppliers are the best in terms of polymer technologies. Whatever polymer you talk, Kevlar, you talk about Teflon, you talk about spandex, you talk about nylon, polyester, polypropylene, all type of polymers is a end product of DuPont technologies.
Yep.
So DuPont hired me.
Okay.
One of the project in coming up in Goa. That was Nylon 66 project.
Okay.
That was again a big milestone for me. Working with the American standards, American philosophy, American cultures, American engineering practices. It was good learning. Then that time, Kentex, one of the best engineering company in the world, who executed series synthetic. They were doing the all technology engineering for DuPont. They decided to hire me for a joint venture called Thapar Chemtex India Limited.
Okay.
So they wanted to start engineering company in India. They have recruited me just to start the Bangalore office. With 50 engineers working for DuPont technology only.
Okay.
I started Bangalore office, Chemtex Bangalore operation, anticipating it will be just a start and go back to DuPont. But again, my good luck or bad luck, it continued for almost 20 years.
Okay.
I handle almost all projects of Chemtex, many projects in China, Brazil, Mexico, Canada, India, all the projects of Reliance Group,
Indorama group, all the project Indonesia, Indorama, etc.
Sir, as far as I understand, at that time, all the big projects were done by Chemtex only. Chemtex was doing...
No, it was all synthetic fiber. Any project coming up...
Yeah, is... Chemtex was behind it.
So, I worked for Chemtex for almost 20 years.
Okay.
The question is, you think over how the emission goes. City synthetic used to be 3 tons per day.
Okay.
It was designed by Chemtex.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
3 tons, now today you will not imagine, minimum capacity of the polyester plant is 1,800 per day per line.
Okay.
So you can imagine how big it has grown. City synthetic 9-acre land. Now in 4-acre land you can produce 100 times more than the city synthetic. So that is the innovation. So that was...
Yeah, the innovation has increased the productivity to a large extent.
Productivity, innovations and many polymers.
Yeah. So, now tell me sir, one more question which everybody wants to know is that you work through all these companies, and as we understand today, you are running, leading MaxPro Engineers, which is your own company. We would like to know more about MaxPro also, what MaxPro is doing, some of your successful projects, so we understand and we get inspired by those examples.
I'll give you just one incident. Chemtex used to be Mitsubishi company earlier.
Okay.
It was sold to DuPont.
Okay.
It was sold to one American partners.
Okay.
Then it was sold to Italian company Mossi and Didolfi.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that time I was almost on the age of my retirement from Chemtex.
Okay.
Options was very clear. I should buy Chemtex.
Okay.
I should leave because there is working with the American company and working with the Chinese group, there is a big delta. So I thought, let me start my own.
Okay.
And this company where I'm sitting today, it was the Chemtex company.
Oh.
Chemtex has moved out of this office. They have taken the small office somewhere in Bangalore. Still working together. It's not that big, we are enemies. But I started my own company. With almost the same vision, same client, same technologies, and 70% of my staff is from Chemtex.
Okay, yeah, that's great. Because I think they all believed in you. They believed in your capabilities.
Yeah.
They believed in your leadership.
Not the leadership. It's a teamwork.
Yep.
You should be comfortable to work. You should be comfortable to deliver. Okay, so people opted to work with me. And still, again, we are not enemy. Chemtex and us, we are working together. We are associate partners.
Yep.
So still, we share the resources. If suppose very people are there, with people all along on the board. So that's a journey. So last almost 10 years. Is doing good. We are doing same type of project all over the world. You take any part of the world, you see the website, we have done in Germany, we have done in Estonia, we have done in Poland, we are doing number of projects in China, we are doing project in Malaysia, we have done Philippines, we have done Thailand, many projects, we have done Indonesia, and today also we have signed one more project in Malaysia. That is So, it's a continuous business. In India also, we are handling almost 16 to 17 projects. In India, wherever we are doing it, in Karwar, Binda Group, we are doing it, in Dahej, Birla Group, we are doing it. In Ankleshwar for Lodha Group, we are doing it. In Vasa for Velasquam Group, we are doing it. In Hyderabad, AYM Group, we are doing it. So, in that place, we are there. And we are doing for many, many projects, not specialty to the man-made fiber, but another core strength we have developed, that is for the relocation of the plant worldwide. We can be among the top most relocators of the plant from one country to another country.
A plant, you relocate a plant from one country to another country?
Yes, complete plant. Okay. We relocate from one country to another country from concept to commissioning and run successfully.
For example, can you tell me some example from which country to which country you have done this?
Two example.
Yeah.
Last month we have commissioned one plant. We got it from Egypt. That is called Egypt fiber. Oh. APCO. Oh. Alexandria Fiber Company Limited. This is Alexandria from Alexandria of Egypt. Oh. Complete plant of acrylic fiber. We have dismantled, brought it to Thailand, and it has been installed in Thai acrylic fiber. It has been bought by the Thai acrylic fiber group, and we installed complete plant, commissioned last month successfully.
So the whole plant which was in Egypt, you took it in a way and started it in Thailand.
That's great, sir. Year before, we relocated one plant from Germany and Poland. Big size plant, you must have heard the name of Enka. Enka Synthetic is a world famous biggest plant, of best quality plant, viscose filament yarn. Complete plant of Enka Germany and Poland, we have relocated to Indian Rayon Veeraval in Gujarat.
Okay.
It is almost about 8,000 tons of machinery.
8,000 tons of machinery, okay.
Dismantled, packed, shipped, revamped, overhauled, commissioned, and total engineering done by this office only. Like this.
Okay.
For group, Japan to Palghar. One plant from Japan to in Gujarat near Baroda, there is a place called Halol. That, likewise, every 1 year we take one plant relocation. That is also one of our expertise in the field. So this is a continuous process. We are learning. We are also improving. We are not doing only EPCM. Generally, two types of engineering people are there. One is engineering, procurement, construction, management.
Yes.
One part is EPC turnkey.
Okay.
So we are in the first grade EPCM also and EPC also. So we do turnkey project also. One plant of Reliance from Odisha, we have relocated to Barabanki.
Okay.
We have dismantled our Reliance plant, shifted to Barabanki, but this plant was not installed because of some reason.
Okay.
Sooner we will be installing that plant. This was on turnkey basis. We are doing constructions also. We are doing engineering also. We do all type of logistic also.
Okay.
So this is the difference.
So right? In a sense, it is true turnkey. You take the key and then you say.
Generally, I use the word concept to commissioning.
Concept to commissioning. Okay.
Pre-project activity also. Mm-hmm. Means, suppose you want to put up the plant, first thing, in this list. What you will do? You want the pre-feasibility.
Yep.
My plant will be feasible or not. Site selection.
Mm-hmm.
Whether where I am installing it is good or not.
Yeah.
Third, logistic, where I will be getting the raw material. So this is a call feasibility report.
Yep.
Logistic support, I make bankable pre-feasibility and detailed project report.
Okay.
To the client decide on the basis of this pre-feasibility and banking report whether he should put up the plant or not.
Yeah.
Then he take the site. Now things are two. Either I can do the job on EPCM or EPC. Client say, bhai, I wanted to go just like to go to Maruti showroom and give me the key.
Yeah.
Okay, this also can be done. You give me the land, I will buy machinery, I will bring the technology. You decide your parameter, how many ton of product you want, what will be your raw material. You come after 18 months, I will give you the key of running this plant. This is the one way. Second is EPCM.
So, sir, in generally, any project will take this kind of time, 18 months?
Again, some of the projects are 18 months, some of the projects are 12 months, some of the projects are 9 months, depending on the size of the project. Bigger project that we are talking today, wherever this polyester plants or paper and pulp plant, another type of plant, Kathapa group, another thing, we are just with the 4 or 5 groups. Reliance is one, Indorama is second, third is one group, fourth is our group, fifth is all this ABM and other group. So, Indorama logistic other group, that is a specialty product of our special hand closure, surgical hand closure, medicine. So we are not going for many different type of clients and other thing. Now important is bigger project maximum you say is 24 month. Bigger. Nowadays nobody want 24 month. So everybody is setting the target for 18 month. Some projects are small projects, 6 month, 8 month also. So depending on the size of the project, we work it out. We take the small project also, then bigger project also.
So sir, tell me one thing. Now a project of so much tonnage, a project of relocating from one place to another place, I think this would be, these are very complex projects.
True. The surprises are more in the such type of project.
Yes.
In my life, I must have handled more than 30-40 projects worldwide relocated. More than 40 projects.
Okay. So here I would like to ask you one question. Because when there are so many surprises and you are working worldwide in situations with certain uncertainties, where social uncertainties are there, political uncertainties are there, I just want to ask you one question. Sir, what are your toughest projects? Can you share with us?
See, again, this session will be very small. Suppose I start describing that.
But one or two.
See, surprises can be of different nature.
Okay.
One surprises, if suppose the plant you dismantle and you find machinery not working, okay, machinery is outdated, or your computer systems or your programming, you cannot get the documentation. This I am not talking. But fun thing is, when you started working with the countries like Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, the biggest problem is how to handle the mafias.
Oh my God.
So the biggest problem is sometimes you are not having that because you are ultimately engineer.
Yeah.
You know how to handle mafia.
Yeah.
One day somebody want to sell the plant, he will sell it to say Birla Group or Reliance Group or somebody.
Yeah.
And they hire us, Mr. Khanna, Mexico team should go there and start spending plant and bring it to us. Ultimately, they are not there.
Yeah.
Once we are there, you will get the surprise, somebody will come, like a mafia, big, different type of person.
Yeah.
here we want this compensation. We are the consultant only. How we can give? No, we don't want to listen consultancy or client. You take it from here, but you have to pay. Now the biggest problem, I will tell you sometime here, a big, big problem. Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan is a full of mafias. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Full of mafias. Even suppose I am loading the containers on the railway track and they will divert the railway track to some other track if you don't pay the money.
They can divert the track to some
other track. Yes. They can divert the container itself. You will not know.
Okay.
You dismantle machinery, tomorrow you will find that machinery, whatever you dismantle, it is not there at the site. It is gone.
Right.
So, such type of surprises, to handle them, it's a very, very difficult thing. And sometimes is a life threat also to some of our people.
Mm-hmm.
Either take you hostage.
Achha.
And they have taken our people hostage also. Yes. I have seen such type of case in Barcelona when I was relocating one plant from Barcelona to Egypt.
Mm.
PCP plant was there.
Mm.
One of my, I think you must be knowing Mr. Bangur, who was also from Ujjain Engineering College.
Mm.
He was with me. He was kidnapped.
Mm.
He was kidnapped and had to pay a lot of compensation to get him released.
Okay.
So, like such type of surprises keep coming, but ultimately, we are sitting on the platform. When I was handling one project in Mongolia, in China, the biggest problem is food habits.
Mm.
I am in South. My 90% people are vegetarian.
Mm.
95% people are pure vegetarian.
Mm.
And the Mongolian people, they don't understand what is vegetarian, what is a non-vegetarian.
Mm.
To take care of their health. And I remember it. I will give you another example. I had been to China along with Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Mr. Bagrodia when this SARS was there.
Oh my.
This plant in Daqing.
Okay.
Daqing Binder Group carbon fiber plant was supposed to be commissioned during the SARS. Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee was also there along with Mr. My 16 people team were there.
Okay.
Now, today we are talking Corona, that time it was SARS.
Uh-huh.
Yeah? And we have taken that challenge.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a life. Life, you will get surprised on every day basis. Once you decided you are engineer, you have to be prepared. You will get the surprise on a daily basis.
Yep.
Once you run the plant, there can be surprises. The quality is not coming. Someday there is all accidents also, someday some products are not coming up, someday some conventions are not there, sometimes some other type of issues. I have seen many. Nylon 6-3 plant, why it has been dropped? Nylon 6-3 plant of Goa, after spending 40 crores by the DuPont and the Thapar, they have to stay. Why? Because there was an environmental issue.
Yeah.
People were registering this on the street.
Mm.
Ultimately, two residents of the Keri Ponda village was shot dead.
Mm.
And still the site is half complete. See, this type of surprises will always be there. So we should not be afraid of that.
Mm.
So my biggest challenge was there. My 18 people were on different site before this corona.
Mm-hmm.
Still my one person outside in Malaysia. That's all people to bring them here.
Yeah,
it's a surprise. It's a really big challenge.
Yeah,
in Thailand, being special for getting back to India, quarantine here, quarantine there, this medical test, that medical test. So this type of surprise. So see, again, this is a part of life. Once you have taken the decision, you have to be prepared for all the things, right?
So basically, what you are saying is an engineer should be comfortable being uncomfortable.
Yes. See, I told you very openly, engineer has to take the challenge.
Okay.
He should be ready to take the challenge. Mm. He should be innovative. And again, he should bring some value addition.
Yeah. Yeah.
What is the difference between engineer and other?
Yeah.
You should always think over what more. Still, I'm hungry. I am not even the ABCD of the polymer.
Oh.
So, it's a continuous improvement, continuous learning.
Yep.
So, every day, if I go to my client and client asks me, okay, you second project also I'm giving you, but I want 15% minimum more improvement on the first project.
Okay. Yes.
I will take the challenge.
Okay.
But I can cut and do the cut and paste. I can do the repeat plan myself. But I want from you for the 15% improvement. So this is a continuous improvement. It's a continuous improvement. Engineer has to think over. My vision is I will be bringing value addition on the table. Yeah. I will be giving something more what the client is expecting.
Yeah.
Why the client will come to you? Client also has an engineer. No?
Yeah.
They also have people working for them. And they know better than you.
Mm.
Why they come to consultant?
Yeah.
Consultant means you should know more than them.
More than them.
You should bring value to them.
More value than they, what they can produce themselves.
Otherwise, it's simple. It's a cut and paste. Reliance 20 plus.
I'm interrupting you, sir. Sorry, but I would like to know how you create that kind of value. How many people are there working with you now? What kind of people are they?
I have about 110 engineers working with me.
Okay.
I have 5 offices, but in Bangalore office, I'm talking 110 engineers working with me.
Okay.
I have all discipline. I have civil, I have mechanical, I have electrical instrumentation, I have the process chemical engineers, I have the project planning, scheduling, monitoring people, then I have the logistic people and procurement people. So I have all discipline.
Hmm.
If I have to make it out of the plant,
yep.
I need an integrated approach. All the people, structural engineer, civil engineer, mechanical engineer, piping engineer, electrical engineer, instrumentation engineer, logistic instrumentation, all the people should work together to make the model and walk through of the plant.
Okay.
Means is not made, but your digital plant with walkthrough is ready.
Okay.
It is animated plant. I run on my system to see whether this plant is walkable or not.
Okay.
Any pipeline is falling and crossing the beam, or any cable is crossing the pipeline.
Mm-hmm.
Person can walk safely or not. If I have to do the maintenance, how I will do the motor? Any plant where you can see everything. So this is possible when you are working with the integrated approach of all the discipline. Then I have the office in Mumbai.
Mm-hmm.
They are taking care of my procurement part. Mm-hmm. I have the office in Delhi. They are taking care of my construction division. They have about 1200 people.
Mm-hmm.
They have to tell me, you have to heard the name of Satna Global Engineering. They are my partners.
Okay.
They are my partner. They are doing construction. I have the office in Canada. I have the office in USA. So all these offices, and then in addition to this, I have associate in almost every country.
Okay.
In every country. Because somewhere there is a requirement of double taxation, somewhere there is a requirement of visa formality. Sometimes there is a relation requirement for the largest support. So they are associate, they are helping my office. So without such type of associate, it is very, very difficult to work. So which country you go, you will find one associate.
So definitely, sir. So what kind of engineers, from which institutes would you take all these engineers?
Today, I can say you engineering people from almost all the big college to the smallest college, from IIT to the local engineering colleges, from the diploma institutes also, but I don't take IITI.
Mm.
Many qualification required is diploma holder. That is only for designers and draftsmen. But generally, I prefer now no diploma because then I prefer they should also be qualified engineer. So I am grooming them. A engineer can work on the systems also, develop on the software also, and can work on the site also. So the person should have the flexibility to work. So most of the people today, say 60% people are from south. It is not really, but people from Bangalore, people from Chennai, Hyderabad, Kerala, and other people, they are more acquainted to this place, so that's why they would like to work with us, number one. Yes. In addition to this, many people are from North India also. Many people, we have taken some people from Indian Engineering College also, Motor was some other people there, they are trained here, they go to Canada and other places. So like this.
So there is a great news for all my listeners, all our audience today, participants today. Khanna sir is a Jesuit. He started from the same college where we all started. And today he is hiring from the best colleges, including IITs. So,
yes.
So if we really have that passion, that vision, I think we can do whatever you want to do in life. And I think that's a great message. Just hidden up somewhere there, which I just want to underline for all of us. And sir, ek cheez main aur puchna chahunga ki mujhe pata hai ki aap Ujjain Engineering College ke liye, Gesu ke liye bahut kuch karte hain. Aapka dil hai aaj bhi Ujjain ke saath juda hua hai, Gesu ke saath juda hua hai. To hamare jo current students hain, unke saath unka level up karne ke liye, unko employable banane ke liye, kya karna chahiye aapke liye?
So, right question you are asking. Important thing is there. Our college is not an inferior college compared to any other college in the world. Mm-hmm. We are at par to them. Mm. See, again, the question coming out is not me or somebody, but people from Ujjain Engineering College, they have come to the top 4 position in the world. I go to various clients. Some of our college people, I feel proud. Yes, they are in a very strong and very strong position. Many people college has given us. Now, important thing is, college needs little more support.
Yeah.
What support? See, today you are coming from engineering, which is more or less theoretical knowledge. You do this, you should do this. Now, suddenly you are going to an industry, you have to perform immediately day one.
Yep.
Client cannot expect ki basically now I will teach you this software, teach you this philosophy. He is expecting from the day one because he is paying you. Now this gap is there. What is this? This is software learning. Now what is basic tool needed for an engineer is AutoCAD.
Yep.
Basic tool need, say, for the civil engineer is state pro analysis. How he will do the analysis? Basic tool needed for electrical is ETAP. My mechanical is ETAP. For every software, how he can run. Now somebody wanted to become planning engineer, project engineer.
Yeah.
He could have the basic concept of MMRA or MMRA. How you make the planning? Now, this training, some of the people are taking only in the institute.
Yeah.
And institutes are not having the right versions, light software to train them. They are giving some basic certificates and other things is not useful. So our college, last time also I came to the college, I gave the lecture. I gave the sessions, lectures to all the people. I can help this college in terms of directly one to one from my different discipline to discipline. interaction, knowledge sharing between my team and college people.
Okay, okay.
Train them so they should come to some better level comparing to what they are today.
Sir, that will be great. Yes.
So I have formed a team also. That time I came, I brought all my 5 department heads. I have given the lectures. I have formed a team. They are also core team. But it could not work because of some people. They could not coordinate or whatever. Lucknow was there. I can fix it one day. That day, every discipline people, my people and their people, they can interact. They can have the software training programs and they can learn. They can question it. They can be having the open interactions and learning. So this can be the better idea. They can come to that level. Number one. Number two. Number two level is, generally we talk about standards and the specification and the general used in the, see, Perry book or our college book,
yeah.
It's a general, but yeah. What standard will we use where? Nowadays, I will give the simplest, worst example. When I came from my college and went to series electric and somebody told me vessel, okay, this sheet is 4 meter by 8 meter. I mean, my boss started laughing at me, Mr. Khanna, you designed 4 meter, 8.5 millimeter thickness plate. First thing you tell me, in the market, 8.5 millimeter thickness plate is available. Our 4 meter wide plate is available. So you have to use the specification standard which is applicable in the course. Now course, if they don't know, so designing is a planning, but ultimately you have to verify your design along with the course and standard. So they should have a list of the course and standard.
Okay.
People should know every discipline. What is the course applicable here, my design? So this is the learning required to bring level. Otherwise, people are nice, they are flexible, they are go-getter, they are very strong people, I can tell you. I have seen Ontario Engineering College people. I have taken many people in JK Synthetic also. Series Synthetic was commissioned not by anybody else, but all by Ontario Engineering College people. Then you, Manaklal Agarwal, Sirolia, Rajkumar Jain, and all the peoples, Tandon, they were all from Ujjain, R.C. Sharma, Electrical, Civil, also all the people, they were from Ujjain Indian College. And how this plant was commissioned successfully that time? Yeah. See, they were go-getter. They can work round the clock.
I think, sir, आपने नब्ज पे हाथ रख दिया है. कहीं ना कहीं उज्जैन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गेसू के लोग जो है वो दे आर स्ट्रीट स्मार्ट. कड़ी से कड़ी हालत में कैसे रहना है, कैसे एडजस्ट करना है, कैसे अपने आप कुछ काम करना है, इसमें माहिर है, इसमें कोई शक ही नहीं है. और आई थिंक वही कहीं ना कहीं चीज, वो DNA आपके अंदर उस ऊंचाई पर पहुंचा कि आज आप पूरी दुनिया में अपना सिक्का जमा रहे हैं, पूरी दुनिया में काम कर रहे हैं. और दो चीजें तो आज इस सेशन से, इस एपिसोड से निकल के जरूर आ रही है. एक इंजीनियर की ओथ मैं आज आपसे ले रहा हूँ. इंजीनियर की ओथ हम क्रिएट करेंगे, अगर वो नहीं होती है तो हम क्रिएट करेंगे मिलजुलकर.
yes.
तो आज एक बड़ी चीज निकल के आई. और दूसरी बात, उज्जैन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज के स्टूडेंट्स को बेहतर सॉफ्टवेयर का यूसेज कैसा होता है इसको बताने के लिए आपकी टीम रेडी है, आप रेडी है, और हम कॉलेज की अथॉरिटीज के साथ भी मिलकर काम कर रहे हैं. एंड ऑल ऑफ अस विल ट्राई कि ये कैसे हो सकता
है. बिल्कुल, आप से इनिशिएटिव ले लीजिए, मैं यहाँ से पूरा लाइनअप कर दूंगा. ऑलरेडी मैं 2 लेक्चर दे चुका हूँ इस सब्जेक्ट के ऊपर.
हाँ जी,
हम उसको जल्दी जल्दी, जैसे ये कोरोना थोड़ा खत्म होता है, इफ इट इज नीडेड आई विल ब्रिंग माई टीम बैक टू उज्जैन एंड वी कैन इंस्टॉल सम सॉफ्टवेयर ऑन द सिस्टम्स एंड वी आर remotely also you can work on my systems.
Yep.
So I give the systems access. people can work on daily basis, because even today I have more than about 70-80 softwares here. Okay. And it's nothing. Again, I don't advise our college to buy all type of software. So this software approach I can give, and these people can work on my software without any hesitation.
तो सर ये बहुत बड़ी बात आप बोल रहे हैं, इट्स योर जेनरोसिटी, और मैं आपको उसके लिए धन्यवाद देता हूँ। आज हमारी जो टॉक है इसमें मैं एक चीज बोल सकता हूँ कि आपका जो पैशन है, काम करने का जो जज्बा है, जो डिलीवरेबिलिटी और अकाउंटेबिलिटी के लिए जिस तरह से आप डिटरमिंड है, वो कहीं ना कहीं हमारे सभी श्रोताओं को बहुत गहरे तक छू कर गया, बहुत गहरे तक छू कर गया। मैं चैट बॉक्स में
एक और चीज बोलना चाहूंगा सबको, जनरली द वर्ड इज डिप, डू राइट इन द फर्स्ट टाइम, डिप, इंजीनियर शुड थिंक ओवर ऑलवेज, अगेन एंड अगेन। इंजीनियरिंग में ये वर्ड बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, मैंने कर दिया, अगेन आई विल रीडू, अगेन आई विल करेक्ट इट, अगेन आई विल डू इट, is the repetitions of the job, it will not support. So my idea is very clear, do right in the first time.
Yes.
Because this, if it is delayed, we see another word, price of non-conformance. किसी नई चीज को बनाना आसान है, किसी गलत चीज को ठीक करना बड़ा मुश्किल है। तो इंजीनियरिंग को ये चीज सोचे, उसका कॉन्सेप्ट इतना क्लियर होना चाहिए कि मैं जब बना रहा हूं, मैं फर्म हूं, मैं कॉम्पिटेंट हूं कि जो मैंने किया है ठीक किया है, उस पर कंफ्यूजन नहीं। सो इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर ऑल इंजीनियर, दे शुड फर्स्ट फोकस वेयर दे वॉन्ट लाइक, उनके बाद बहुत ऑप्शन है। मेरा ऑप्शन है, कोई बोलेगा मेरे को तो 35 साल में रिटायरमेंट होके इतना पैसा कमा लेना, मैं आराम से रहना चाहता हूँ, क्या दैट कैन बी ऑप्शन। दे शुड नॉट चूज टू गो टू इंजीनियरिंग लाइन, दे शुड गो टू सॉफ्टवेयर लाइन, दे शुड टेक सम अदर ऑप्शंस अदर देन द इंजीनियरिंग। इंजीनियरिंग में इट इज नॉट ए इजी फास्ट अर्निंग, इट्स ए लाइफ टाइम यूर एप्रिसिएशन, लाइफ टाइम रिकॉग्निशन, एंड यू विल फील प्राउड। आज मैं बोलता हूं मेरे 60 प्रोजेक्ट 70 प्रोजेक्ट कर दिए हैं, तो इतनी कंट्री में कहते हैं मेरे को, ये मेरी अर्निंग है, ये कि बेसिकली आई मेड दिस ऑफिस अदर थिंग। सो इंजीनियरिंग को पहली चीज फोकस करना है, वेयर ही वांट टू टेक हिज लाइफ, नंबर टू ही हैव टू फोकस व्हिच लाइन ही वांट टू गो। इफ यू वांट टू गो टू पेट्रोकेमिकल, यस ही कैन मेक बेटर मनी कंपेयर टू पॉलीमर, बट इट इज हायर। Then he should think of refinery. Oh yes, I will go to refinery. Fertilizers. Yes, these are high end. Or इससे ऊपर अगर किसी को जाना, yes, I will go to nuclear plant. हमने अब ये बताया, somewhere nowadays that हमारे कॉलेज में एक सब्जेक्ट होता था काइनेटिक एंड सिंथेसिस, अभी है कि नहीं पता नहीं, हमारे प्रोफेसर एसी राव हमको पढ़ाते थे, वर्ल्ड फेमस सब्जेक्ट था काइनेटिक एंड सिंथेसिस, इट इज फॉर डायरेक्शन मिसाइल्स एंड अदर थिंग। यू टू फील प्राउड, उस समय पे इंडिया में सिर्फ 4 कॉलेज में ये सब्जेक्ट होता था। पर वो काइनेटिक सिंथेटिक सब्जेक्ट में क्या है, हाई एंड। आज आप उस सब्जेक्ट में पढ़ोगे तो यू विल गो एंड सिट इन नासा, यू विल सिट इन इसरो, यू विल बी विद द डीआरडीओ। तो वो विजन आपको रखना है, यस, आज डिसाइड कीजिए कॉलेज से निकलने के पहले, कॉलेज में घुस, don't think over, I will go one step ahead, then I will see, oh no, no, yeah, this subject is not good, let me go back. No, this you cannot think over, because going forward, backward, going forward, backward, you will lose your time and integrity. So, you engineer should make their mind where I want to live my life. I want to make the fast life. Trading karwa, yeah. Many people are doing trading, na? So trading करो, तो basically one day here and one day there. Plant को इधर उधर बेच दीजिए, you will make millions and million dollars. But the reason is today, if you want to make your life, you have to choose what you want to be in your life. That's important message to all of my friends.
So at some level, it's engineering of our life, basically, more than just machinery. अपनी जिंदगी में वो फोकस चाहिए, अपनी जिंदगी में वो क्लैरिटी चाहिए. सर आज का सेशन आपके साथ बहुत मोटिवेशनल था, बहुत इंस्पायरिंग था, एंड एट सम लेवल यू पुश्ड अस टू थिंक बियॉन्ड आवर लिमिट्स. मैं आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ सर.
और थैंक यू पुनीत. आई विल लव टू बी हियर ऑन द डिफरेंट सेशंस वेयर एवर इट इज रिक्वायर्ड. एंड एनी पर्सन
मुझे लगता है कि और भी सेशन की जरूरत है, और थोड़े डिटेल में पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट्स में भी हम जाना चाहेंगे कभी कभी.
एब्सोल्युटली एनीवे, बट आई एम टेलिंग यू फ्रेंड्स ऑन द अदर साइड, आई एम अप्रोचेबल ऑल द टाइम. यू हैव माय नंबर, यू हैव माय वेबसाइट, माय फोन नंबर इज ऑलवेज ओपन राउंड द क्लॉक 7/24 hours. सो एनीबॉडी वांट एनी क्लेरिफिकेशन, एनी हेल्प, एनी सपोर्ट इन माय लाइन, प्लीज कॉल मी. ओके
राइट सर. तो सर एक मिनट में दूंगा हमारे सब श्रोताओं को कि अगर वो कुछ कहना चाहते हैं आपके बारे में, कुछ चैट बॉक्स में कुछ लिखना चाहते हैं, तो वो अपने जो भी भाव है वो प्रकट कर सकते हैं. जनरली एवरीबॉडी इज बाउड आई वुड से, एंड पीपल आर सेइंग हैट्स ऑफ टू यू.
थैंक यू.
लगातार देख रहा था, लोग कह रहे हैं कि बहुत ही इंस्पायरिंग सेशन था, एक्सलेंट, ग्रेट सेशन. मतलब मैं लगातार चैट बॉक्स पे नजर बनाए हुए हूँ, और मुझे लग रहा है कि कुछ लोग बोले वर्ड्स ऑफ विजडम एंड होप इट हेल्प्स. सर आज मजा आ गया मुझे. मैंने शुरू में कहा था कि आई वाज रियली फीलिंग हम्बल, एंड इवन नाउ आई एम मोर हम्बल.
It's my privilege to be with my people here. Basically, see, I have a very special affections for my city, my hometown, my birth town, and my karma bhumi, rang bhumi. Even I'm an artist also. I'm a dramatist also. Jyoti Swarup and Tiwari and Khadekars, all the people from our college, we used to play Mahabharat, Rangai and other things.
तो एक नई बात पता चली मुझे, ज्योति स्वरूप जी का नाम तो हम सब याद करते हैं और उनसे मिलने की तमन्ना रखते
हैं. रंगभूमि आल्सो फ्रॉम देयर.
ओके,
यू शुड हैव वन हॉबी आल्सो इन योर लाइफ, विजिबल.
यस,
ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स ज्योति स्वरूप एंड अदर पीपल, दे आर इन द वेरी स्ट्रांग पोजिशन. रघुवंशी वाज आल्सो देयर, प्रकाश रघुवंशी. From our college, they have come to good film industry, film line. Unfortunately, could not go. I have also had the offer to join film industry.
Sir, अभी तो आप जवान हैं, अभी तो आप बहुत कुछ कर सकते हैं. हो सकता है वापस भी चले जाएं.
Only for capital.
तो मैं सबकी तरफ से आपको शुभकामनाएं देता हूँ, और आपकी इजाजत हो तो यहाँ पे विराम लगाऊं.
Thank you, जी. Bye.
Okay. तो दोस्तों, जय हिंद, जय भारत.
Thank you.
Good night, and we are stopping this session now. What a wonderful session it was.